In this video, we are going to look at how I took these photos and how I went from knowing nothing at all about analog photography to taking these photos, developing them and scanning them with a really cheap and fast method. So what was not cheap, however, was the camera I decided to purchase, the Mamiya 645 with the 80mm f1.9 lens. The whole package with a couple of lenses and a couple of viewfinders and a hand grip cost me around $600. But obviously you can buy a much cheaper film camera. There are a lot of cheaper alternatives out there. But I have always really loved the look of the 80mm f1.9 lens from Mamiya, so I decided to splurge and buy this camera. What is also nice about this camera is that it is pretty compact considering that it is medium format. And what I ended up liking a lot about it is the simplicity. You only have the focus, the aperture, you have the shutter speed, and a simple light meter in the prism viewfinder. And that's about it. There is nothing else to worry about. And coming from digital photography, it's really nice to not have a menu system and stuff like that to worry about. You can very quickly feel that you know everything there is to know about how the camera works. And that is a very nice feeling. And it fills your whole body with a certain calm. This is the second viewfinder that you can use. It does not have a light meter, so I haven't used it that much yet. I really like the prism viewfinder where you have a light meter built in, so you know that you're exposing correctly. But this is a more classical look. And in the middle there you see the rings that help you focus. It took me a couple of rolls of film to really become comfortable with nailing the focus. Especially at f1.9, that aperture is equivalent of f1.2 on full frame when it comes to depth of field, so it can be pretty hard to nail focus. But if you've done a lot of digital photography with manual lenses, you have learned a lot that is of use with this camera. I also purchased this lens. I haven't tried it yet, 55mm f2.8, small and nice lens. And this hand grip, I also haven't tried it yet, but it certainly will come in handy. I decided to purchase this black and white film. It's a classic one called Tri-X 400, so it's ISO 400. And I like the look of this film, and 400 is good because then I can shoot indoors without much of a problem. You will also need a development tank. This is the classic Patterson kit. It is quite cheap, around $30 or $40, and with this tank you can load the film into it and then you can develop in a light room without a problem because the film is safe inside. And normally it is quite a hassle to develop film yourself. You usually have to have several baths in different specific temperatures and so on. But with this mono bath solution that I found for black and white film, you only need one bath and you only need 4 minutes of development time, and you can do it in room temperature, which is super nice. And I ended up loving this film developer. So let's take a look at my first experiences using this camera. I looked up the official guide on how to load the film. It was pretty straightforward. And then you just crank the lever until it stops, and then you're ready to shoot. My first model here was my son Max, who seemed really, really interested in the camera. Which makes it kind of hard to photograph him, because he always wants to touch the lens and to carry away the camera. But I tried to have some patience, and in the end I got a couple of shots of him. As you will notice, many of the shots in the beginning of this video are very, very grainy, and that is because I made a mistake in the development process. I will tell you about it later and how I corrected it. And you will also see some examples of non-grainy pictures. Even though all pictures taken with a 400 speed film will of course have some grain in them, If you really hate grain, then either film photography might not be for you, or you should get a film with 100 in speed, and then you will have less or almost none of the grain. So one thing that was a bit hard getting used to this camera was that it is really, really bad ergonomically. I mean, many people give Sony a bad reputation for having a bad grip, but this camera has no grip at all, so it really takes maybe 3 rolls of film until you learn to hold it in a way that feels safe and that you feel that you can control it easily and take the picture when you want to take the picture. So that took some getting used to. But once you shoot maybe 3 or 4 rolls of film, it actually feels very nice to use this camera. And you can even nail focus pretty quickly once you gotten used to the focusing mechanism. So I decided to also take a walk with Max to do some landscape photography with this camera. And during this walk, I had only shot maybe half of one film. I really started to realize that it is so much fun with film photography. I have waited quite long before trying it. I mean, I've been into photography for a couple of years, and for only now I start trying film photography. And that is because I haven't been excited about it at all. I've had a hard time seeing the difference between photos taken on film cameras and on digital cameras. And I've also been really, really worried about all the work that comes with developing and the cost of buying film. And yeah, I've always kind of felt that film photography is not for me, it never will be. But this time I just decided I will try it a little bit just to have done it, to learn something maybe, and then I will sell the film camera after a couple of weeks, and that's it. But during this first walk with the camera, I really realized that wow, film photography is something different. It is a lot more meditative, and since there is so much hassle with taking every picture, you have to get the focus right, and it takes a while to nail the focus, you have to meter the light, and this whole process around taking a photograph, which many people might see as something really annoying. I actually discovered that this puts you in a completely different rhythm. You calm down a bit and you become more meditative. So this actually makes the process of photography a bit more enjoyable, I would say. Sure, with modern cameras you can more efficiently and quickly get the job done, but if you're only doing photography for the joy of it, as I do, then film photography might really be worth considering. Developing film was a lot easier than I thought, at least with the monobath solution that I used. Links to all the things I used are in the description of this video. It only takes around 4 or 5 minutes in room temperature to develop one film, and you only need to use one solution. Go look up the manual for the Patterson tank to see how it's used. There are also a lot of good tutorial videos on YouTube. Then, to scan the film, I developed this little ghetto solution, an iPad with a white screen. You can actually Google like white page and you'll find a web page that gives you a white screen. And then a little bit of distance between the iPad and the film surface, because otherwise you might get the pixels from the iPad in your photos when you scan them. And then I used a normal 40mm lens and a small extension tube to be able to focus closer. I use a 13mm extension tube to get close enough to the photos, and then I just put them here in the cutout box that I used, and just place the photo like this and make sure that iPad shines from below. It's good to do this in a dark room. I did it in the bathroom so that it could be completely dark, so that you get better contrast. And then I just used the delayed release of the shutter so that the picture becomes sharp. And then in Lightroom, you go into the curves and you inverse them like this to get the negative to be a positive. Yeah, and then you just adjust the image a bit and you have a very cheap scan. As long as you have an extension tube of around 13 millimeters, which costs almost nothing, that's basically all you need. Here are some more photos that I took with this camera. And the less grainy ones are from the fourth roll of film, the ones you're seeing now, where I learned that to develop correctly, you should be careful with not stirring the bath too much. I stirred it violently for the first three films I shot, and that made the pictures very, very grainy. So that's good to know, you should stir it lightly. It was a whole different experience than I expected to shoot film. It was a lot more fun, a lot more involving. Of course, it's more work than digital photography, but I would say it is very enjoyable. And then of course I might find it enjoyable just because it is new to me, we'll see. But I definitely will buy a few more films, and I will probably also try color photography and color development, because it would be very interesting to try that as well. But I can really recommend you to try film photography if you feel that you need some new inspiration and some new perspectives. Guys, don't forget to subscribe to my photography newsletter, a free email newsletter that goes out once a month with my best inspiration and tips about photographers and so on. Sign up at mwroll.com. And please give me a like on this video if you did like it. It helps this channel a lot. And you are subscribed, I hope. I put out new videos every week, at least I try to. And I also have an Instagram account. See more of my photos at mwroll on Instagram. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon again. Over and out. Bye.